I heard you speaking about, you know, how Colombia used to be, you know, on the low, and then they are high now, especially with eradication of crime in the country. How do you think Nigeria can get there?
Yes, we can be there. You know, that is why I said all of us have to come together and work together so that we can face this problem that we are having. You know, whatever problem a nation has, the nation have to bring in her people together, let everybody understand this is the problem on the ground and this is where it is going, and these are the things that we are supposed to do to curtail this problem. And we need all hands to be on deck so that we can bring an end to this. This is what Colombia did. 30 years ago, the rate of kidnapping in Colombia was like more than 5 times what is in Nigeria. People can't travel for like an hour journey. Even if you want to travel for a distance of like 50 kilometers or 100 kilometers, you have to make preparation for your own kidnapping. Yes, because you have to get your bag, you have to, if you are taking some drugs, maybe hypertension, diabetes or whatever, you have to get your drugs for like 3 weeks, you have to get your clothes for like 3 weeks, you have to get your soap, you have everything that you need. But this is a journey that you want to just go and come back same day, but you make preparation for your own kidnapping. So you can imagine how bad Colombia was 30, 35 years ago, but they have reversed the whole trend. The country is very peaceful now, security-wise, very, very, very secured. So we saw what they did, and we see that it's something that we can also do. So all those challenges that we have, be it security, be it economical challenge, or be it whatever, when we are able to bring our people together, we let them understand what is on the ground and where we are heading to and what we can do, you can see that we can achieve it. So please, that is my advice to my younger ones, our youths out there. Please, you have a lot of resources, you have a lot of skills out there. If you can look at it and see how you can work on it positively, you know, you can look at all those great guys in the US. Look at the guy that created Facebook and all those big, so many other billionaires that are young guys, you know, you can see what they can achieve. So we have a lot of talents like this in this country. Yes, we know the environment is not as encouraging as what is obtainable in the West, but still, with the little that we have, we can still do more better. If we can all come together, put our minds together, dedicate ourselves, then you will see that there is nothing that we cannot achieve. As I said earlier, you know, we, like somebody like us, somebody like me, I don't have any godfather in this job. Yeah. When I was coming into this job, I don't have any godfather. I followed through all the process of the interviews and came in. And when we started working, we put in our best into whatever we are doing, because we always believe that whatever we're doing is worth doing well. Yeah. So from there, we were able to move forward. We were able to achieve a lot of things. And then our leaders, you know, all this while recognize what we have done, and you can see that they have rewarded us with so much awards, so much promotion and what have you. So all those things is something that anybody can do. So that is why we always encourage our youths that whatever they are doing, they should put in their best. Yes, it should be tough. It is not going to be easy. You have to make a lot of sacrifices, because it's always very easy when you follow the shortcut. But when you say you want to climb to the ladder, and then you want to do something outstanding, you have to make a lot of sacrifices. But I don't really to work. When you make all such sacrifices, you will see that your country will recognize you, the people will recognize you, and then at the end of the day, you will appreciate what you have achieved, and then it will encourage other young ones that are coming up to also do same or even do better than you. So that at the end of the day, the country will, at the whole, be better, because if everybody from all aspects of life is putting his best in whatever work he's doing or whatever profession that you are doing, you will see at the end of the day, collectively, the country will be great. So this is what I'm praying for my country, and this is what I'm hoping that would happen. Just like other countries like Malaysia, Indonesia, Korea, and what have you have done, South Korea have done, we can also do it.
We're talking about that. As a security expert, do you think that social media should be regulated in terms of security of the country?
Well, actually, I don't want to comment on social media issues, but it has a lot of positive sides. We all know. But as far as the regulation of social media, well, I think I don't want to comment on that.
Okay, I understand that. Okay. Thank you so much, Samuel.
Thank you, sister. I'm very grateful.
You're welcome. Thank you.